Nahmuduhu nisalli ala rasulil kareem. A'udhu billahi min shaitanir rajeem. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Brother Saif, I think you should understand that was not the only recommendation that Brother Ramiz spent some time with you. We all spent time with you, mashallah, and everybody remember all those good memories. You spent some time overseas, but then, mashallah, you are here. So I will also be quick, because we like to hear from Brother Amir Muhammad, Imam Khalid Griggs, and then Sister Dalia Mujahid. She will be here shortly. So I was given the topic, why ICNA CSJ? So I will say very quickly, because you will be finding, you will be watching a video about ICNA CSJ. There are material on your chairs, on your tables about ICNA CSJ. There are future projects and all other, whatever we are doing, inshallah, that is there. I will say that there are three perspectives. One, you already heard the Quranic perspective, that this is the Muslim, as a believer, this is our duty to stand up for justice. So this is a Quranic perspective, and Rasul Akram Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Sira also told us that even before Nabuwa, he was doing that hilful fudul, standing up for justice. But more than that, in Surah Al-Hadid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent all prophets, messengers, with bayanat, with signs, with mizan, with scripture. What is the purpose? That ultimately the human affairs should be established on justice. So I think it is very perfectly fit for us in America that all prophets, the Christians understand them prophets, Jewish understand them prophets, Muslim understand all of them prophets, that their purpose was here. Ultimately, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has explained that the human affairs should be established on justice. The second perspective is the American perspective. In the preamble of the Constitution, it's written, the people of the United States like to have a perfect union through established justice, and some other qualities also it was explained. And then we have ICNA perspective also, Islamic Circle of North America. It was established in 1968. And during the 70s, there was an Islamic party in Washington, D.C. Imam Khalid Griggs was part of that. That Islamic party also established justice committees in different cities. In ICNA, as ICNA was evolving, first they put emphasis on dawah, organization, and tarbiyah. Then after a couple of decades, they started the social service work, ICNA Relief. Initially, ICNA Relief was doing both the domestic and international. But then when time passed and we have more experience, we divided our work to social service in USA and internationally separate ICNA Relief and Helping Hand for Relief and Development. But then around 2008 and 2009, we discussed among ourselves in Shura and other settings, yes, working for poverty, working for alleviation of poverty, giving support to hungry people, this is to some extent sustaining poverty. We have to discuss the reason of the poverty. We have to discuss and we have to be on the table where policy is being made. So for that reason, we established ICNA Council for Social Justice, that we'll go for the policy, we'll go for the reason of all those issues, focus in this land, and we will be partnering with other faith-based and non-faith-based organizations working for elimination of poverty, against racism, and against unjust immigration policies, Islamophobia, injustice to indigenous people, family breakdown, and also, yes, global injustice. So that evolving work of ICNA compelled us, alhamdulillah, that we established ICNA Council for Social Justice. So you will be finding more information about that. I will just two more points, but I will finish that and then you have 1 minute? Okay. Just on your table, There is a report, Inventing Terrorists. We work with the Coalition for Civil Freedoms, and we published that report. This is all September, after September 11, all cases, 600 plus cases against Muslims, where Muslims were got arrested and they are put in prison. The two lawyers, they analyzed each case, each and every case, and came to the conclusion that 93% of those cases, they were not on terrorism basis, but they are just some minor mistake in immigration. And second thing also, and this is a very last point, that as I'm saying that our DNA is the working with all other organizations, Muslim organization, non-Muslim organization. And I think the best demonstration the American Muslim community have seen during this Kashmir crisis in the last 3 months. Every organization, they work together, and ICNA CSJ, we feel little pride on that, that alhamdulillah, in New York and Houston and all other cities, we got together, we become a glue between Muslim organization, Kashmiri, Pakistani, Indian Americans, USCMO, Masajid, the Shura Council. And the result was, I think the last 2 days before when there was a hearing, I think we felt the result. All those meeting at the grassroots level with congressmen and congresswomen, and they raised very severe and challenging questions to the government official and the witness. So I think you will have some flyer also about that. So inshallah, when we're at the end of the program, inshallah, we will have more information about why ICNA CSJ and what they are doing. Thank you very much. Wa akhru da'wana, alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.